Check, 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 there it is. There it is.
Is that my call from London? I'm really stoked about the revival. It's really exciting. I feel like there's been a ton of excitement building up around
I had this awareness of hot trash for years. And, you know,
it's still very much a community affair.
It's going to be great. I'm excited.
Our shows were amazing.
Yes.
We had the privilege to
be
there.
We were in theirs, and I emceed a bunch.
Hot trash will never die.
Hot Trash is my favorite fashion show in the world.
I've never worn it. It's a big night. I've never worn it.
I did my first Hot Trash in 8888.
I'm so glad Hot Trash is back.
It was such a great show, and we got such great feedback that we couldn't help just feeling totally high when the show was over.
What do I know about Hot Trash? Well, I know one of the models. Yeah. She's way hot.
The trashier the better. I want it really trashy.
This is the best place to be.
I can hardly wait.
Joystick belt complements the ensemble, further accessorized with a Tandy computer part hat, a way too slow fax modem necklace.
Well, we'll have a lineup printed and posted back there, so we'll have.
We as designers be on, and then the models come on.
Okay, so we'll be opening
yes,
now.
Yes, you can interact with them with your face, you know, with your face. Yeah, some
I
of the, you know, some of that is
I don't know.
That's beyond.
We'll do it. Hurry.
Ah. I broke a nail. So yes, I think she's here with us. She'd be really happy that we were all doing this, don't you think?
Oh, I think she's here. I just tingled all over.
I know.
Yeah, it's been 11, 12 years since we've had a show. I'm excited that people want us to do it. I didn't think we'd be doing it after we lost Susan and Crystal, but I think it's great.
When we did the 1990 show, it had gotten so big and we had 14 designers. And so I contacted everyone I could find of the old designers, and happily we had 7 of the old designers this year and then brought in 3 new designers too.
It amazes me how many of us came back from out of town. And
well, I moved to Hawaii in 1988, and the shows here continued on through 1991, so I came back and I participated in them.
I've been the chief voyeur on this mission since its inception. It's been my allotted task and pleasure. And I like how many people are involved, and I like the fact that the models are between 6 and 60. There's been a 10-year hiatus. A lot of the models are now designers.
Some of the girls that were real young back in the day when we did Hot Trash, and one of them is even a designer now, 8 or 9 years old when we did the last show.
Oh, Flora!
I want to thank everybody who showed up and all the time and energy you guys put in. We could never do the show without you guys and those of you. Of course, we have a number of seasoned models who just jump at, oh, you know, I want to be in Hot Trash. There's always those last-minute things where you lose your model and, oh my gosh, all of a sudden I have to find somebody to wear this. And a couple of the girls that we pulled in that way this year were just, it just turned out to be an incredible experience for them.
I think it's great if all these beautiful women want to wear my trash. Sure, you know.
I'm modeling Victory Through Vegetables and Poolside Party.
This is really royal flushes inside, but you can see how many different cards. Usually the more annoying something is that I have to toss out, the more likely I am to make something out of it. Well, I have a biohazard ball gown that I think is kind of a timely piece. It's for my daughter to wear to the nuclear winter ball in Washington, D.C.
Now Flora is prepared for the unknown with her faux particulate respirator. constructed from a variety of household trash. With these blue plastic garbage bags gathered and ruffled within an inch of their centuries-long life, and embellished with impossibly delicious little orange construction tape bows, they guarantee to drive the sanest man wild with desire. Wearing the latest in vintage government-issued acid rainwear, it's designer Ozona Slash. Made from broken umbrella tops, this tiered ensemble creates the 40s and 50s layered look that is so stylish and so very practical, especially if your skin is burning.
One of our designers, Judy, who came on right at the very end, she made some of the most elaborate stuff in the whole show. I just look at her pieces and think the lint outfit, and of course the famous thong bikinis.
And so very trashy.
Give me your dirty love.
Does anybody know what kind of glue you're supposed to use to keep pasties on?
She did not go to the Burning Man pasty workshop.
Your dirty love.
I've been in my youth, yes, and perhaps in the future. I have pictures of many strange friends wrapped in interesting garments.
Your sweet devotion, and I don't want your cheap emotion. Give me up some dragon lotion. Give me your dirty love.
I've been modeling for Hot Trash since it started, pretty much. I wore inner tubes back then. Inner tubes and plastic wrap. Those are the days, man, when we used to wear plastic wrap. They don't put me in plastic wrap anymore.
I'm who I am today because of polyethylene. That's true. And Dr. H and Open Mic and the whole social science crew.
Social science made.
I developed my aesthetic at that time. It really was significant in developing the artist that I became.
Been following him ever since.
Yeah.
Is it true that this is the highlight of the haute couture fashion here in Nevada City?
Oh, it is.
We're talking to Ozona Slash, a new designer this year. Are you ready for your interview? Three questions. Are your outfits for sale?
Oh yes, definitely. High fashion costs though, you know.
When fashion and science collide.
Hot Trash.
Yep, 1990.
Your dirty love.
Hope to see some of you here tomorrow night for Hot Trash number 2, 1990.
And the main driving force behind this whole crazy thing, and I don't know how she pulled it together, but she sure did. Our own wonderful polyethylene.
Polyethylene, the founder of the entire show. What do you think about this year's show?
I think it's marvelous. It's the collective work of 14 women, and I'm impressed with all of their designs.
Why do you do this? We really want to know. What's the truth?
Well, Mark Twain used to perform at this theater, and he once wrote a book about a young man named Tom Sawyer. And I have to quote Tom Sawyer and say, "For the adventure of it!"
Susan's a really tough act to follow, I must say. I don't think it really hit me until dress rehearsal night what we had done and were about to achieve when everybody showed up with the costumes, and all of a sudden I was just like amazed and got real emotional, you know, thinking about Susan a lot. Everybody just, you know, kind of breaking down in their own ways over, you know, what we'd really pulled off. But.
And I'm just so thrilled we're getting to do this. For me, it's just totally to honor Susan.
It's really exciting that the legacy lives on. She just kicked it off and now it has a life of its own. And that's the most fitting memorial. She'd be very pleased with this.
Susan had a little show called Social Science with Hank, and she asked me to model a trash outfit. They were rather elegant, but they were very simple compared to today's Hot Trash standards.
The first show I was involved in 1986 was the first show that had more than one designer. It had three designers, and I was modeling in that show, and it was all real basic kind of construction stuff.
I just became so aware, and so did Susan, of how much usable materials we were pulling out of the dumpsters that people were throwing away. The dump shall provide became our motto.
Our 50-pound size Brazilian cashew nut bags. The latest in Mountain People's metallic line of fabrics.
jewels cut from Armor Star bologna wrapper.
Anastasia, modeling for Rihanna, Miss Queen. Look at the black plastic bow dotted with pieces of...
And somehow it grew into a whole show. We thought we could do a whole evening of them, because people just responded so well.
From Eve's House of Original Sin. Cliff is wearing a 20-gallon throwback vest, studded with bottle caps.
This state-of-the-art swimsuit was created through a process known in the business as trash transmutation. It consists of a steel sack garbage bag encrusted with acrylic mirror chips and is encoded with a circuitry pattern for a vertical interval lighting display.
Well, if my eyes don't deceive me, it's the modern fertility goddess. This is Lady Madonna wearing a design by Mary X.
It also gives us a forum to get up and make fun of anything we want to make fun of.
Modeled by Hell for the Yeoman Knight. Here we have it. Cover up. It's converted from discarded virgin solar mesh screen material that's been rated with an avowed 69 sun protection factor. We are struck at once by its balanced stability. Only afterward do we discover that the balance has been achieved by coat hangers, bedding wire, and the Stigmata gloves made with... With each month of the current year floating gracefully around your body, you can, with confidence, accept or decline any future invitation on the spot.
Tonight, there'll be rigid arrows here, and it should be a hell of a lot more interactive in that they're so rude and rustic.
This is the big night.
For me, it's really about the opportunity to work with a lot of creative people and have fun and laugh a lot and get other people to laugh a lot.
What do you know about hot trash, young coach?
Hot trash is just the hottest thing around. It's nothing better.
It was great. I'm addicted. If it gives any kind of a spark that people take home with them, I'm really glad. That's the real joy of hot trash, is having a really good time.